Audi can't really go wrong at the moment. They just celebrated their 100th anniversary. And of course, in typical Audi fashion, they're celebrated by bringing out yet another new model. Now, you might look at it front on and think you know exactly what this is. It's an A5 coupe. Well, you'd be wrong. This is the Audi A5 Sportback. It may look very similar to the A5 coupe. It's got a very nice coupe roofline, but here's the difference. It's got two extra doors, so you've actually finally got rear seat passenger space, unlike the A5 coupe, and it's got a further door around the back. It's got a tailgate, very nice tailgate, up to a very big and impressive boot. Audi say that this is very much the car for the saloon buyer who wants the good looks of a coupe, but wants the practicality of his saloon. This is the car they think answers all of the questions. What the Sportback is all about, though, is extra space. In the A5 coupe, you have got two rear seats, but only the tiniest can sit in them. It's totally impractical. In this car, this is what Audi say is the answer for people looking for two proper seats. I don't sit in the back of a car very often, to be honest. I'm not a very good backseat driver, you'll not be surprised to know. But I'm sitting in here now, and room-wise, it's very, very nice in here. I've got enough knee and leg and headroom. I'm not the biggest of guys, but for me, I could travel quite a long distance sitting in here quite comfortably. On twisty bends, I'm not quite as sure, but on a long motorway run, this car is fine for an adult my size at least. I'm driving the 2-litre FSI petrol, and this is one super smooth motor car. It really is the perfect example of how you can get performance and fuel economy out of a modern 2-litre engine. What I like about this Sportback is how effortlessly it switches from being a relaxed and almost silent motorway cruiser to a really nimble, agile car for its size when you hit bends, and there are plenty of beautiful driving bends in the Tuscany mountains. Being an Audi, of course, it's crammed full of technology, from different suspension settings to a whole load of gadgetry. But probably the most beneficial thing to your ordinary motorist is this features the latest stop-start technology and regenerative braking. So have Audi got another winner on their hands? To be honest, I'm not totally sure. Part of me really likes this. I like the practicality of it. It's very, very elegant for a 5-door. It does everything you would want. The drive isn't that coupe-ish, but there's a lot of car for your money there. The question is, will this take people away from Audi A4 saloons, or even, dare I say it, the A5 coupe?